What you say?
Say what?
Say that.
Listen, you probably are going through what I've already gone through, or you're thinking what I'm thinking. So with that in mind, say that. Okay, it's the holiday. It's Christmas time.
Tis the season to be jolly, not for everyone, la 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 la's.
Everyone is not jolly during this season. It's a lot going on. I can only start with myself.
Listen, I understand that this is the time to be festive and merry because that's what we've been told throughout the histories and throughout the years and throughout this.
Celebrate, you know, this is the time for Christ's birth.
Listen, I'm a licensed ordained minister, right? I believe in what I believe in when it comes to Jesus the Christ, but I'm not religious. It's about a relationship. We should be celebrating people and giving gifts on a regular basis, but that's not what this is about. What this is actually about is the fact that there are people during this time that got some things going on that's not so joyous. You know, for myself, this is the month of December, the month that my oldest child, my firstborn, passed away. December 15, 2016, I had to put my son, or I got the notice that my son was no longer in what we call the land of the living. So it was literally the day after Christmas that I flew from California back home to Baltimore to lay my firstborn to rest. The first child I pushed out, I'm now pushing down in the dirt. But that's not what this is about either. What this is about is having support mechanisms, people in place during this time, and being real to be able to say that, to share with somebody that you love, who you know has your best interests at heart, know who will encourage you, impart into you, uplift you, and things of that nature, because this is a very overwhelming time. Then we'll add COVID in the mix, so it's not like we can really go over our friend's house and fellowship and have fun and laugh and joke and all that, because everything's pretty much still shut down. People sick. People are passing away from this thing, so we can't even go out and do that right now. But I'm saying, though, pray, encourage, and uplift those people who are out here going through this season because it's needed. Okay, you can't go to their house, but you can make a telephone call. You can put a Facebook post. You can inbox them. You can Instagram them. You can leave a message. You can do something to let somebody know that, listen, you're thought about right now. You're not alone. Listen, if you just need my ear for you to talk to me, because I know for myself, as strong as people see me as, and I am, as anointed as people see me as, and I am, as talented as people see me as, and I am, I cry. I need a shoulder to lay on and lean on. And even though I hear God tell me it's going to be okay, I need people to tell me it's going to be okay sometimes too. It's that human touch, you know, that sensory of touch that we need sometimes. Not to heavily depend on it, but it's definitely needed. And I'm like, so this is the time of the year. Hug on somebody. Don't be upset if you can't get people nothing for Christmas. Listen here. I just moved from one state to another, right? I'm starting up my business again, like putting my content, doing things that is taking finances to do. But I'm a single parent. No, I'm singly parenting. And that's going to be another YouTube. That's going to be another message that you guys get, because there's a difference between single parenting and singly parenting. Single parenting is when you are the only individual, you know, 100% like taking care of your child or children. But single parenting also can consist of a village of people helping you to do things, helping you raise that child. When you are singly parenting, you don't have that support system on a consistent basis. But what I have found is I have found people to be my ambulatory service. They have come in to resuscitate me when I'm in critical condition. Even though some of the people know that I'm in critical, won't go all the way through, because as you can see, I'm a communicator. So I tell people what's going on. But at the end of it all, it's a challenge for them to help me navigate through it, to keep it this way. But they'll come in like the, you know, rescue engine fire number 99 or the ambulatory service and go, oh, I see that you are about to die. Let me resuscitate you. But did you know that I was slowly getting sick to this point, or whatever the case may be? But again, we'll talk about that later. Right now, we're just talking about this holiday. It doesn't have to be holiday blues. You know, it could be holiday good news. Give somebody the gift of your ear. Give somebody the gift of your heart. Give somebody the gift of your time. And that can be done without any money. so you don't have to be stressful about not being able to get anything. And you don't have to worry about going over to somebody's house because, you know, so you won't catch COVID or anything like that. You can do it from the comfort of your home. But please don't get upset because you can't buy anything. Listen, I'll be the first to tell you, I don't have it either. My kids are not going to celebrate a monetarily gift-giving Christmas as it comes in material ways because I don't have it to give to them. But let me tell you where my peace is, though, because you have to understand this. My peace comes from the fact that I give them all throughout the year. So if you are giving somebody all throughout the year, don't you feel bad because you can't give right now? And if you're not giving to someone throughout the year, here is your first notice or your reminder that if you give throughout the year, you don't have to wait or save up for one day to be able to give because you've been giving it all along. So for me and my household, I give time, I give encouragement, I give support. I probably give them the blues too. I give them the blues too. But I give throughout the year so that one day a year, I'm not going, oh my God, I feel so bad that I haven't been able to. Because I have. Like I said, I've been single parenting for years. Even being married, I was a single parent. Sorry, check that out. I'm just being real alive, so my alarms are going off and people are texting and calling and all that stuff. But I've been a single parenting for years. And I remember my first Christmas, and I don't want to make this too long, but I remember my first Christmas. I was 19, I had my own place, and I had my son when I was 18. So my son is 2, he's going on 2. 18, 19, 20. Let me see. I had him in 88. This had to be the Christmas of 90. So he was, 89. He was 1, going on 2. And I didn't have it. I mean, I was 19. I had rent. I had a car. You know, I wasn't working full time. Social services, you know, I mean, if you're working, you know, you ain't really getting nothing. So, you know, that wasn't jumping off. So I'm just like, I'm so sad and hurt because, again, I hadn't had this knowledge and understanding to giving until, you know, later years. But back then, you know, I was used to Christmases and, you know, big like tree and big gifts and stuff like that. And with that being said, I'm like, oh, I don't have it to give. I reached out to my grandmother, and, you know, she was like, I'm gonna put your name in the church box, baby, and I'm gonna make sure that you get something. And it was like 2 or 3 days before Christmas, and they knocked on my door, and it was boxes of toys and clothes and food, and I cried because I was like, dang, I can't even provide for my kids. But my perspective was off, because what I should have been saying at that time, I know now, but what I should have been saying at that time was, God, thank you that you provided what I needed. Thank you for making provision, because I know that what I was looking for somebody else, it was for my child. I didn't want him to go, and even though he was like only like, what, 2, going on 2 years old or whatever the case may be, I still didn't want him to not have. And the crazy thing about it is, I would love to tell you that that was the first time that ever happened, but not at all, honey. I think he was about 5 or 6 years old, again, still being a single parent. And struggling, you know, because now I'd have moved out that little apartment. I got me another car, and I'd have got me another house, because, again, that place wasn't conducive, you know, for raising a kid, you know, rodents, all that stuff. You know, I've been through all that, you know. So took him to another place, and he had to be about 6 or 7 years old. And I just remember that happening again. And, you know, someone giving my name to a church or to an organization that helps single parents or whatever, or help individuals with low income to be able to provide a good Christmas for their children. And like I said, I know now what I'm telling you now, and that is to provide a good holiday Christmas for someone, for your family, for your loved ones. Give them something that they actually need in this hour. They need your time. They need your ear. They need your heart. They need your support. They need your empathy. They need your compassion. They need you to hold them accountable. They need for you to make sure they're being responsible. Those are the things that we need right now so that we can become a better person. Our best self, to live our best life. That's what I do. I'm imparting. I'm sharing me so that you know that you can win. And I mean, I'm sharing me so that you can know that you can overcome as well. Because I ain't special. Listen, I wasn't born with no silver spoon in my mouth. Nothing special. The same thing that I've been given, you've been given too. And you can do this too. Not that I'm telling you to pull yourself up by your bootstraps. What I'm saying is you have the ability, the innate ability to be able to overcome. Sometimes you just need somebody to connect with you to pull that out of you. And that would be me, impartation strategist Renee, being rebirthed and out the box. And that way I'm going to stay that way. You know what I'm saying? Say that. Catch you on the next video.